Performing Arts. Please take a moment to silence your devices. In the unlikely event of an emergency, locate and proceed calmly to the nearest accessible exit. Comply with any official instructions. We would also like to remind you to enjoy refreshments in the outer lobby only. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, intermission is over. Shall we dance the night away? wife for me. I will not wed, for you are my love, my love.
Thank you. Madame Glavari, you are simply divine. You sparkle like a diamond.
Well, I do like diamonds.
Please, Madame Glavari, let me welcome you to the embassy. This is my wife, Valencia.
Lovely to meet you. May I present our dear friend, Monsieur de Rosillon?
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
I'm sure you will find him suitable.
Gentlemen, would you please escort Madame Glavari to the ballroom? I do hope you like dancing.
I could dance all night!
Pontevedra. Madame Lavard.
Oh, it's you. I thought you might be here. I was hoping I was wrong.
What brings you to Paris?
As you may know, my husband died. It has been suggested, given my youth, that perhaps I should remarry. Of course, you don't believe in marriage, do you?
What are you talking about? It was you who did not believe. At least in marriage when love.
I don't think you should talk about love, since clearly you love only yourself.
What do you mean? It was my uncle.
Yes, your uncle who convinced you that I was too poor for you and made you break your word.
But not your heart, since it was immediately available for another suitor.
I have my reasons for marrying. Your uncle might see things differently now.
If you think I ever cared about the money, you don't know me at all. In fact, I was on my way to tell you that I...
Oh, let's not fight. It was so long ago. I need a moment. I swear I left it over here.
Well, it's gone now.
Why did you write I love you on it?
Because I do.
Darling! Have you seen Count Danilo?
No, my sweet.
Oh? Nietzsche said he was in here. But all I find is the two of you.
We were looking for the widow.
Ah, Danilo, finally. I have a mission for you. It's top secret.
I'm proud to serve my country. I don't know anything.
You are to be married.
No, sir, not that.
The fatherland commands you.
And to whom does the fatherland need me to marry?
The widow, Anna Glavari.
Absolutely not. No way, no how.
But she must marry a Pontus Adrian, or the country will go bankrupt when her taxes go to a foreign land.
Well, sir, I will have to find another Pontus Adrian for her to marry, as it cannot be me.
Lady's choice! The lady's choice, gentlemen.
Ladies' choice, the event of ladies' voice. So Madame may hide your hand on hers. I'll let up your hand, one less is one alone. All my there to go, supremely happy I will leave you in. Just me.
Don't leave me overwhelmed by your condition. Gentlemen, I find I'm in an embarrassing position.
No, madame, I do not dance. My dance, you told me so.
I did, what then?
The dance is mine, then, gentlemen. I can do what I like with it. As I admit, that so.
What
does he mean? Dance for which I know. Since my dance is worth at least 10,000 francs. Yours the dance may be, if you'll give 10,000 francs to me for charity.
Thank you.
Major will always be in our hearts and minds. We must always be ready to support the fatherland, even in its darkest hour.
Darkest hour? Is Pontevedra in trouble?
Trouble? No. Everything is just splendid.
Glad to hear it. Well, I hope you don't mind, but I have planned something quite Parisian for this evening's festivities. A surprise for Comte Danilo.
Oh? Niche, did you know about the surprise?
Of course, Your Excellency.
Since Count Danilo is so taken with Shane Maxime's, I decided to rent out the entire place this evening and see what all the fuss is about. I even hired his beloved grisettes for the entertainment.
I'm sure Danilo will be quite taken with this surprise.
And now, excuse me, gentlemen, but I must go see no one's drowning at the lake. No worse way to spoil a party.
Where is Count Danilo? And do you really think it's a good idea for her to see him at Che Maxime's?
Look, there he is, sir.
Where have you been, sir?
I was out all night. I haven't even been home yet.
You know Pontevedra has great need for your services. You must marry the widow of Lavari. She seems quite fine.
As I said, I cannot marry the widow of Lavari. I will, however, prevent her from being wooed by any amorous foreigner. Have any of those Frenchmen made any progress?
Yes. I have heard from a very reliable source that Camille de Rosillon is quite taken with her, and that she returns his affections.
Baron Popov, where did you hear such a thing?
Why, from my wife, Valenciennes. She says he only has eyes for the widow.
I'm not sure that.
So keep your eyes on him. Let's all go enjoy the party and meet back here at 6 o'clock to discuss our next move.
As you wish, sir. I'll be back here at 6 p.m. with bells on. What is this in my pocket? Ah, the fan. I forgot about this fine. I love you. Well, the plot thickens. Excuse me, ladies. Did anyone of you lose this fan?
No.
No.
Oh, going for a swim, are you? Well, I didn't bring my suit, but perhaps.
What have you got there, Count? A new fashion accessory?
It's a fan with I love you written on it.
I hope for your sake, gentlemen, does not belong to any of your wives. This Count Danilo is quite the ladies' man.
I didn't write that on the fan, I just found the fan.
Can any woman be trusted?
My wife is the perfect example of fidelity. But it isn't blitz, right?
Women are the worst.
And the best. Oh, ladies, wait for me.
What's the saying? Can't live with them, can't live without them.
Well, actually, you can.
So and so and so.
marry another man?
You should marry whomever you want.
Wonderful! Then I shall announce my engagement later tonight.
You are already engaged? It's been 2 days! You've done it again.
What do you mean?
When I left, I went to my uncle to beg him to change his mind and convince him that I must marry you.
You did?
Yes. And he relented. But by the time I returned to tell you, you were otherwise engaged.
Well, how was I to know? It was a long time ago.
Yes, it was ages ago. Maybe this time I will get to dance at your wedding.
Why don't you dance with me now? One last time.
My dear husband, Popoff? Valenciennes, no!
Oh, say no more!
Will you not let me?
Please marry Anna and forget me! This very night your offer must be spoken!
It shall be done, although my heart is broken!
It is my heart, my love, my fear.
has already been occupied.
What do you mean? Who's in there? A woman? What's going on? Stand aside! It's Monsieur de Rosillon! With a woman! Niche! Lock the back door so they can't escape.
What are you doing?
Shh! Monsieur de Rosillon is in there! With a woman!
Who is she?
I don't know, her back is turned. They're kissing!
Can you see yet?
She's turning around.
Oh my god.
What? What is it?
It's my wife. It can't be.
I'm sure you're mistaken.
He was kissing her. My Valenciennes. What shall I do?
All denounce her! Open up! Come outside right now! What? How could that? I swear it was.
And I was blinded by my soul.
It's come near my very heart stand still. The case is very much too clear.
But where can my wife be?
I'm here, dear.
I am done distraught.
What's going on? I'd like to know.
Thank you. should I raise objection so? I give you my maternal blessing, only I think.
What do you think?
Love when you may, propose but seldom, marry not at all. A marriage in the olden way is wholly out of date today, and as a friend has told us, quite undiplomatic. Yet if a lady marries me, a modern wedding it will be. I promise, in a style emphatic. We make a little change of me. Instead of two, we'll have the same, just like a sister and a brother. But when the ceremony's done, wherever you may meet with one, you won't expect to find the other.
In fact, you'll find it safe to say we are a pair, entirely up to date.
It's true.
I live the truly born Parisian, in the Parisian style. My ego soul that will be changed in a Parisian style. And as I shan't be on the shelf, not for a little while, I'll go ahead and place myself in a Parisian style.
Treachery past my believing. those words of a prince's not mine. His fury then rose to its climax.
Go take him! I've finished with you!
With that, the prince coolly departed, and so will I know. Adieu! Where to? Where to? Somewhere I can feel at home. I'll go off to Maxine's. I'm done with lovers' dreams. The girls will laugh and
Thank you.
Why would she do that?
Why, for you, of course.
I mean, Madame Bovary. What a splendid idea to have a party at Maxime's.
And what better place to celebrate my engagement to Monsieur de Rossillon?
I need to speak with you.
So serious?
I forbid you to marry Monsieur de Rossillon.
Why?
Because...
Well, you will need a better reason than that.
He's French!
You are jealous!
Jealous? That's absurd.
Don't worry, I'm not really engaged. I was just having some fun at your expense.
Papa, my friend! Good news! She is not going to marry Monsieur de Rossillon. Her millions are still safe with Pontevedro.
Oh, thank goodness! Madame Bovary, should you get engaged again, please, for the sake of the fatherland, choose a Pontevedro.
But Baron, according to the terms of the will, if I remarry anyone, I forfeit my entire fortune.
You what?
Oh, we are doomed! Perhaps staying single is truly the best course of action.
You would have no money at all?
Not a penny.
I love you. I love you. Will you marry me?
You would have her without any money?
Of course. I have loved her since the moment I met her.
I accept. I would be honored to be your wife.
I'm very happy for the two of you, but madame, if you lose your fortune, Pontevedro will be bankrupt.
Not quite, Baron. You see, the will states that if I marry, I forfeit my entire fortune to my new husband.
Oh, thank God!
While penniless and filthy rich, I would still like to marry you.
I always speak words unspoken through you here. Waltzing steps keep time unbroken still within. Heaven awaits an answer. Do you love me true?
Public? How dare you?
How dare you?
Maybe
dear husband, Popov!